Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Al-Qadhi Abdul Jabbar mentions that there are two challenges that were made in the Quran that were frustrating and confusing to disbelievers from among his contemporaries. The first challenge was, of course, the challenge of the Quran, because naturally, if it was met during the time of the Prophet, peace be upon him, that would have been it, no more Islam, right? The second challenge was the challenge that was made against the Jews in Medina. Say, if the home of the hereafter with Allah is for you alone and not the other people, then wish for death, if you should be truthful. But never will they wish for it, ever, because of what their hands have put forth, and Allah is knowing of the wrongdoers. And you will surely find them the most greedy of people for life, even more than those who associate others with Allah. One of them wishes that he could be granted life 1,000 years, but it would not remove him in the least from the coming punishment that he should be granted life, and Allah is seeing of what they do. So the context is pretty straightforward. The Jews who hated the Prophet, peace be upon him, and rejected his message came forth and announced that it was only them that would enter paradise. According to Judaism, you don't need to be a Jew in order to enter paradise. I would suggest checking out this video on Trini's channel for more on the subject. The Quran provides a very simple challenge. It's very straightforward. Wish for death if you are truthful. Simple as that. Now, while the Jews were looking for any method to expose the Prophet, peace be upon him, any way in order to get the upper hand, they simply did not wish for death. Ibn Abbas states in Musnad Ahmad and Tafsir al-Tabari through an authentic chain that if the Jews actually wished for death at that specific time, they would have died on the spot. And the fear of dying from uttering this falsehood actually prevented them from saying, yes, we wish for death. Now, how would the Prophet, peace be upon him, know this? How would he know that they wouldn't do this? How would he know that they wouldn't wish for death? How would he know what was in their hearts? And that, my friends, is a sign of prophethood. See you guys in the next one. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.